Welcome to iOS 26, where there's now a built-in assistant to screen your calls. I'm calling with your top tips for iOS 26. Please pick up.
Thanks, Joanna Stern. Please stay on the line.
New messaging tricks, like polls and backgrounds, live translation in calls, and did I mention a completely redesigned liquid glass interface that nobody asked for? But there are ways to tone down that glassiness. And I'm pretty sure Tim Cook decided to jump from iOS 18 to 26 just to see if I could do it. 26 tips for iOS 26. I'm insane. Number one, lessen the glass. This is basically what your iPhone looks like now. Liquid glass makes all the menus and toolbars translucent, which looks cool until you've got a bright background and overlapping text. To really get rid of the effect, go to Settings, Accessibility, Display and Text, Reduce Transparency. That will remove the translucent look of almost everything. If you just want to lessen the effect, try the Increase Contrast option. To be clear, you do get used to the liquid glass look after a while. Number two, glassify your home screen. For those who want to embrace liquid glass, there are a few new tricks, especially on the home screen. Hold down and select Edit in the upper left, then Customize, then Clear or Tinted, and all your icons will now match the background. Now I can't find anything. You can also extend the glassy clock on the screen, which is pretty cool. Number three, revert your phone app. I really don't like the new phone app. To go back to the old view, select the three lines at the top right of the calls view, then select Classic. We've gathered today to mourn the top-mounted search bar. It has now moved to the bottom almost across the entire operating system. Number four, set up call screening. This is one of my favorites. If you get a call from an unknown number, the software will ask who's calling.
Hi, if you record your name and reason for calling, I'll see if this person is available.
Then it will send you a message and transcribe what that caller said so you can decide if you want to pick it up.
It says, hey, you Jazz, I want to talk about your car warranty, of course. Who's you Jazz?
You Jazz, and I want to talk about your car warranty.
Ah, huge ass, I get it now.
Number five, use Hold Assist. Right now, I'm on hold with Apple customer support, but I don't have to sit here and wait on hold. Go to More, Hold Assist. It says you'll be notified to pick up. It runs the call in the background and mutes all the audio, so you can do other things on your phone. I guess we wait. Liquid glass. It says all Apple advisors are still busy. Please continue to hold for the next available advisor.
Hi, Joanna. How are you doing today?
Not bad. I just wanted to let you know I'm recording this call.
Well, if you record the call, I cannot continue, Joanna.
Seriously, one of the best features. Number six, live call translation. Did you have a nice summer?
Es cierto, pero tuviste un buen verano.
Sí, excelente. Viajes cortos y combinado un poco de trabajo. Feliz.
Yes, excellent. Short trips and combined a little work. Happy.
On a call with someone who speaks a different language, you can go back to that same More menu and select Live Translation. It's limited right now to English, Spanish, Portuguese, German, and French. There's live translation in messages too, and it supports more languages. All of these translation features require Apple intelligence, which means you need to have an iPhone 15 Pro or newer. Number seven, filter unknown senders. You can now have three filters in your messages app: messages, unknown senders, and spam. Spam is your junk. You know, the texts that tell you you've got a great new job. That's not really a job at all. That one's on by default. But if you want to filter texts from numbers not in your contacts, like two-factor codes or appointment reminders, you can turn on unknown senders. Tap the three lines in the top right corner, then manage filtering, and turn on screen unknown senders. Number eight, add backgrounds to messages. Tap the contact image at the top of the conversation, then backgrounds to change the background. This also works for group chats. Here's the catch. When you change the background, it changes it for everyone in the chat. So if your friend changes it to something hideous, and then you change it to something else, it changes it for everyone, which means you can go back and forth and back and forth with ugly backgrounds. To recap, if you want your chats to look like a GeoCities page from 1997, go for it. Number 9, add a poll to messages. You can add a poll to any message chain. Just tap the plus in a conversation, polls, and add your choices. Apple should have really just called this, what should we get for dinner? I voted sushi. And the Messages app now shows typing indicators in group texts. Finally, number 10, adjust snooze time. In the clock app, tap an alarm, then select snooze duration. Sadly, 15 minutes is the max. So no, you can't snooze until tomorrow. And now, a giant snooze button. Number 11, ask about screenshots. When you take a screenshot, there's now a lot going on. You'll now see new visual intelligence options. Tap search to instantly Google whatever's displayed. You can also circle the item on the screen first. If this sounds familiar, there's a feature in Android just like it. It's called Circle to Search. This is another one of those Apple intelligence tools, so you'll need one of those newer phones to get it. Number 12, relearn the camera app. This might be one of the most frustrating redesigns. Apple stripped the camera app, so you just have the camera and video buttons at the bottom. If you want anything else, you've got to swipe across or press and hold to see all the modes at once. And if you're hunting for more settings, swipe up from that bottom area. Because nothing says simplicity like a secret menu. Number 13, turn on adaptive power. Under settings, battery, power mode, turn on adaptive power. The phone learns your typical battery usage and on higher usage days makes adjustments to help you extend the battery. Halfway through. Number 14, in Messages, tap the Select button and you can select just a few words to highlight and copy, instead of the whole text. Number 15, in the AirPods menu in Settings, enable camera control. Say cheese, press the stem when the camera is launched, and now your AirPods are camera remote control. Number 16, in Apple Maps, Visited Places keeps track of where you've been. If you can't remember the name of some restaurant, you can look at that list. I knew this would come in handy. Number 17, sick of blurry photos? Go to Settings, Camera, Lens Cleaning Hints. It will alert you when your camera needs a wipe. Number 18, when you add a photo to your lock screen, you can select this spatial scene to add some movement to your photo. Number 19, plug in your phone, and here on the lock screen, it will say how long until it's fully charged. You can also see this in Settings under Battery. Number 20, you can combine two emojis. On the keyboard, tap Emoji, then Genmoji, then the two you want. Number 21, in the Photos app, there's an easier way to filter by different types of images, including screenshots. Number 22, in the Voice Memos app, select a recording, then Share, then Use as Ringtone.
Ring, ring, ring. Ring. I will sell you this ringtone for $5.
Ringing. Number 23. If you don't like how screenshots now take up the full screen, go to Settings, General, Screen Capture, Turn off Full Screen Previews. Number 24. I have years of CarPlay screenshots I never wanted, but no more. In that same Screen Capture section, you can turn on or off CarPlay screenshots.
Number 25. The new Preview app makes it easier to scan documents and deal with PDFs.
And number 26.
In Settings, Accessibility, you can turn on head tracking, so you can control your phone with face and head movements. Camera launched. Selfie taken. They said it couldn't be done. 26 tips for iOS 26 in the year before 2026. But I did it. I did. I'm happy I drank some of that wine. I feel great for the iOS video now.